this one has not like fallen off. It is what we thought it would be. Two top five teams in prime time, both with eyes on the playoffs, both undefeated, Ohio State and Oregon. Like, it's actually here, and it's what we thought it would be.
I hope so.
You had a I saw a little bit of doubt there.
Yeah, here's my problem, and look, the odds makers, it's only a 3-point spread for Ohio State. I think that the game was in Columbus, which it's not. I think it would be somewhere between 7 and 10. Autzen's a tough place to play. It's a great environment. Dylan Gabriel would have been my pick. He probably was going into the year to win the Heisman. You have a guy who's played a lot of football, great intangibles, leadership qualities. He's played a lot of big games. He's accurate. The ball comes out of his hand fast. He's mobile. He's very savvy. And all those things, he can light it up the rest of the way. So far, it's been shaky. You know, the offensive line wasn't very good in the first couple of games. It was really shaky. But then what we've seen from him is he's had a bunch of red zone turnovers. Mm-hmm. I mean, 3 picks in the red zone. That is concerning. He's going to play by far the best defense he's seen, most talented. I mean, Boise State gave him a game, but Boise State gave him a game because they have the best running back in college football, Ashton Jeanty. Boise State's defense is by, you know, roughly a middle of the pack defense in the Mountain West. It's nothing like the athletes he's going to see in the front seven. Caleb Downs might be the best defensive player. He might be the best defensive player in the country. I mean, the safety for Ohio State, who was at Alabama doing amazing stuff.
I love how we're not talking about him playing running back anymore.
Because they have two great ones. Yeah.
Running backs. Anyway.
I mean, I think Ohio State's my preseason and current pick to win it all. I suspect we'll see Dylan Gabriel's best game. You know, maybe we'll see him keep the ball and run it more. They don't need him running against Idaho and Boise or Oregon State. They may need him running the ball against the Buckeyes. You know, he's not a tiny quarterback. I mean, he's not Bryce Young, but he's also not Anthony Richardson either.
No, he's not.
We'll see.
I was at the Oregon Boise State game. I was blown away. We all were, by Dylan Gabriel in our production meeting. I had never met the guy. He's mature. He's an adult. He is a leader. He gets it both, I think, on a granular. Both big and small. How about that, Andrew? I can't speak today. But the right side of the offensive line, obviously heading into that game, was a bit of a mess. To me, there was a question, like, had Will Stein been telling him not to run? Like, because there had been some open lanes in the first couple of weeks that they hadn't taken. And he said no, but they also want him to see it, get the ball out quickly. The red zone thing definitely concerns me. I think Will Howard can make plays against those corners as well, those backs. I mean, Quinshon Judkins, his contact balance, his power is absurd. And what impressed me with Ohio State, too, those backs block, those wide receivers block.
Oh, those
they pick
wide
up blitzes.
Awesome.
They block on the edge. I do think Ohio State is absolutely the better team. But Oregon, and we saw it in the Boise game, has the chance at any moment for those explosives. Now, do they get them as much as they want to these days? I don't know, but they at any moment can go 90 yards in like that. I think they keep it close, and I think the home stadium can be a factor, and I also don't know that we've seen the best of the Ohio State defense yet.
We haven't. Our crew, Big Noon crew, had them against Marshall, who's a solid, you know, group of five team. Right. But Marshall actually did some decent things on offense. It just didn't look like Ohio State was that dialed in. The most optimistic part for me, if I'm an Oregon fan, is Jordan Birch, former 5-star edge rusher, big physical. He looks like he could be a first round talent. Derek Harmon, who was formerly at Michigan State, big time 3 technique. Those guys are playing like top 50 picks right now in the last few weeks. And Ohio State's O-line, which is looks very much improved from last year. That last year was a struggle. These guys are good enough and really talented enough at Oregon where they could cause some problems potentially. Because I think they have the stuff to be a high-level D-line, and we're starting to see some of it. But again, Chip Kelly gets a homecoming game, right? Mm-hmm. He was great at Oregon when he ran the offense. Now, he has never, and I would say including in the NFL with the Eagles or with the 49ers, had receivers quite like this, which may sound crazy to say it. Like, he's had good slots and good tight ends, and he's obviously had terrific running backs. He's not had nothing like J.J. Smith, the 6'3", 220-pound freshman receiver. You know, and I obviously had Deshaun, who could fly, at, you know, with the Eagles, but Deshaun was a much smaller receiver. I mean, the guys he has at Ohio State, and it's a bunch of them. It's like five or six guys. You know, Will Howard's not C.J. Stroud, but Will Howard's a big guy who can run and will run. And in that offense, it's a really good scheme. I think this is going to be a really interesting chess match between Chip Kelly's offense with a lot of firepower and a lot of weapons against an Oregon defense that also has speed, but they haven't, you know, they've seen Genty. They haven't seen anything like they're going to see in terms of this group.
Catch the Rich Eisen Show every single day on the Roku Channel, 12 to 3 Eastern, for free.